안녕하세요. 서산 두리 치과 박종현입니다.
Hello, I'm Jonghyun Park from the Seosan Duri Clinic, and today I'm going to talk to you about overdenture. Overdenture restoration, I usually use their locators. So today I'm going to talk about how you can use locators through some cases. So the mandibular bone resorption seems to be severe, but luckily there was some bone remaining on the anterior side, so we placed two implants. And on the maxillary side, we planned for complete denture. And mandibular side for the final impression. So the attachment was attached beforehand. And this is going to be one of the key points I'm going to talk to you today. The final attachment needs to be located before taking impression. I think that is desirable. This is because, as you can see in this wax denture, the space needs to be secured for the locators to go in beforehand. So we skipped all the in-trim process and look at the wax denture. You see the hidden slide, and in this case, the taking impression again and doing alignment again might be the way, but I tried to approach it from different way. I finished waxing first and not making oral adjustment, but here, using wax and silicone, I took the impression again and put that again in the clinic to remove any interference. So I did a further adjustment within the mouth. So let's see how it did go. So hidden slide, making adjustment there within the mouth is really challenging. So to take the jaw relations again, I usually use LOX. So the patient, I just ask the patient to take a bite. And the denture, I make sure that it's stable and it's repeatable. So on the anterior side, I use a silicone. And using the putty, I think putty is the fastest because it has a minimum damage to the denture. And if there's interference, you can see really clearly in the articulator. And I remove that. So by reattaching that at the chair side, I make sure that all the problems are solved. So without sliding, you can see there is a good occlusion. So it seems that the problem of that has been resolved. But here, actually, there was another problem that I had to pay for. So the midline has been moved. So here I really took a lesson. If I knew about the hidden slide, I should have taken the impression again. But by reattaching at the chair side, of course, you can sort of make an adjustment. But there is an anesthetic result, you know, with the midline moving and you see some changes in the overjet. So because you pay for that, chair side adjustments, you just do in inevitable cases. And in wax denture, if you see a problem, you have to fix the problem then and there. So anyway, hidden slide has been resolved, and TS fold abutment is what I used, and this is a key point. Using the fit checker, final attachment, I check whether it's okay. So look closely. You see there is some space that is not full, so I grind it and look at the fit checker, and you see there is a secure space now. And through this attachment, the denture, if it's not stably put in or delivered, then that would be the biggest problem. And for me, using resin cement, I make the attachment. And dual cure resin cement is what I use. What product, I do not believe is that important. And after time, about 5 minutes, once becomes more hard, you watch it again. So you see a bit space, and I try to fill it with resin cement in the past, but now I grind it, and that area I fill it with the flow resin. I think it's easier to use light cured resin, and it has less discoloration. Of course, you could also have other options that is comfortable to you, but for me, if there is a bit of space or loosening, if possible, I use the flow resin or light cured resin to fill the gap. Now, the patient, whether she can put it off and put it back again, you know, of course, it took some time, but I think she adjusted quite well. So it was successfully removed. And after some time, after 1 week, if you see it, you know, detaching and attaching it, I think a patient really mastered it. So, 2 implants was delivered, and then full denture was used, but still, it's really much better than complete denture. So, using fit checker in the right way to see whether everything fit is important. If the locator has interference, then, you know, denture can be not really stably attached. So if there is a space, then using the cement or resin, I filled it up. But as I said, I use light cure resin these days. That would be the only change. So you can see the border have extended on the denture. Even with the over denture, you can have to remember the complete denture location is really important. You have to think about snowshoe effect and the function of the denture, and what denture needs to do, you have to be mindful of that and let it leverage that to the maximum and use the locator as only a supplement. And sometimes patients comes back saying it's painful. And if it's not due to occlusion, but if it's related to it comes into tissue, then I use the marker with the VitaPex and grind it. And after 32 months in recall, I took the panorama photo, and the resin, there was some, something that was missing. So there was a discoloration, but it retained and maintained very well. And patient was rather, was satisfied. So I let it be. But after 41 months, patient said it's really loose. And locator can play a role here. Just changing attachment is enough, and it's very easy to do. So I should have been more mindful. But this resin, maybe I could replace it with the floor resin. Maybe that's something I could have done better in hindsight. So this is how the attachment was replaced, and the patient could still use it very comfortably. So I didn't take photos after that, though I did one more realigning after this. And after 3 years, about in 2020, attachment was placed again. So in other words, attachment in my case, I switch it every 3 years or so. So, and realignment for this type of extended denture, you have to know how to do the surgery. So, in summary, now overdenture is actually good, better than you think, but it takes more time, is a bit tricky because patient has to come to the clinic very frequently. This is because when you place just 2 implants, you know, patient has high expectation, but this is still complementary to the complete denture. So you have to lower the patient expectation. So you have to explain to the patient very well, and that would make it more efficient treatment. And if the patient had used complete denture before, he or she would be more satisfied. So what is important, you know, can really do overdenture well, but maintenance is key, realignment and replacing of the attachment. You have to come to the mask core to learn more about these things, important things. So that concludes this lecture. Again, overdenture compared to complete denture, it's more satisfying to the patient, but still patients do complain. Based on what you learned today, I hope that if you can switch to overdenture, the patient can feel more comfortable. With that, I would like to conclude this lecture. Thank you very much.